After being conceptualized a decade ago, construction began on the project in October of last year. And this Saturday, the grand opening of the new Sparrows housing complex took place. The complex provides semi-independent living for adults with intellectual delays.
Really, it's to take them through. This is going to be their home for years to come. And even till the point where they, you know, they may not be able to walk, still be able to live in their units with wheelchairs.
The home is a partnership between the Sparrows Christian Housing Society and the Bethesda Christian Association. And Vanderberg says it's an exciting time now that the home is built and residents can move in.
Just tremendously excited to be part of a project that, in the end, I came along and dotted the I's and crossed the T's with the board. But the original board members who stuck with it, seeing the light in their eyes, sometimes tears in their eyes, that it actually came to fruition what they were hoping for 10, 11 years ago. And it being so much more than what they were even hoping for at that point. So, yeah. Tremendous gratification.
The home features 6 rooms for tenants, which will give the residents a chance to live on their own, but there's also a common area for them to gather.
On this end of the building, there's a fellowship area or a leisure area or common area, and there is an opportunity there to share the evening meals together. There's a big screen TV, there'll be couches and chairs, and yeah, I'm sure they'll spend many of their evenings there.
There are currently 3 residents selected to move into the house, where they will share the space with the in-home caretaker and the therapy dog. Vandenberg says there are a few other potential residents going through the assessment process, and because there is a definite need for semi-independent living, the society does have a possible addition to the home in the back of their minds, but the expansion won't take place just yet.
There is property that's, might be available. There is opportunity even to expand this building. But it's really, I think, at this point, trying to come to grips of running this thing, running it well, understanding the needs of the individuals, and then seeing what other need might be out there. And then I would say this is step one, but I really don't know where step two is going to come into the picture yet.
For CFTK TV News in Smithers, I'm Karen Coppetz.